Hey guys, in this lesson, we're going to deploy an AWS Elastic Beanstalk application. And to keep it interesting, we'll do a few things. We'll upload a different version of the code, and we're also going to create a second web server environment and see how we can play around with swapping URLs. Okay, so I'm in the Elastic Beanstalk console. Now, at the point in time that I'm recording this, there is a new console. It's brand new, looks a little bit different, and unfortunately, it doesn't work very well. So I have tried it out, and this lab doesn't work correctly at this point in time. So we're gonna have to use the current one. So let's create a new Beanstalk application. Let's give it an application name. I'll just call it My Beanstalk App. We don't need to give it any tags. Now we do need to choose a platform. So what is the platform we're going to use? I'm going to use Node.js. Of course, there's quite a few different options there for various different programming languages. Now I'll leave the defaults and it will upload some code automatically or utilize some code which is sample application code from AWS. So we don't need to change anything here. Now we could just create our application or we can have a quick look at configuring more options. So let's have a look at the extra options so we know what's here. The first thing is we have some presets so we can choose whether we want a single instance or whether we want to go through to things like high availability. We can change the platform here. We can do things like enable X-ray for tracing. We can change the configuration of our instances and update our capacity with the types of instance types we want to use, for example. You can add a load balancer. You can configure the policies for rolling updates. Configure security, monitoring, managed updates, and so on. You can even add in your database configuration here. Now I'm happy with what I've got, so I'm just gonna create my application. So what happens is we create an application, and then within that it creates an environment. So we can see we now have the application, My Beanstalk App, and then the environment, My Beanstalk App-env. And on this page, if I just click on this option here, we can then see a bit of information about what's going on. We can see the console here showing us the actual configuration being created. Now in the background, there's some work going on CloudFormation. So if we head over to CloudFormation, we can actually have a quick look at what's going on. And we actually have a stack create in progress. So when you create a Beanstalk environment, a stack is being created for you. You can come in here and you can see the various elements of that stack. So that should take a few minutes. And once it's finished, we'll have a URL that we can use to connect to the sample application webpage. Okay, so that has completed. We now have our Beanstalk application available. If we go to CloudFormation, we can see that everything is complete. You can have a quick look at the resources that have been created, and you can see an auto-scaling group, for example, launch template, an Elastic IP, and so on. So coming back to Beanstalk, we now have this URL. We can click on this URL, and it takes us to the application, which is just a simple landing page for Node.js. So let's go back to the dashboard. Of course, we've got on the left-hand side here, the environment and then the application above it. And we can see for the environment, we can still go in and configure the various settings. So we can update the configuration, lots of different options here. You can go and have a look at logs if you've updated logs. And you can have a look at the health of the environment, for example. Now, what we're going to do is let's go up to application versions. You can see that we got the sample application. So we only have one version at the moment of our application. In the course download, you'll find a folder called AWS Elastic Beanstalk, and in there you'll find the zip file. Now, this is the same Node.js code that AWS use when we use the sample application. So what I'm gonna do, I'm just gonna unzip that file. I'm gonna come in and I'm gonna go to the index.html and open it in Visual Studio Code. So this is the file. Now what I want to do is I just want to change the background color so we can see it. It's on line 38 here. I'm literally just going to backspace all of these numbers and just type in the word. Let's put blue. Take that one away. Let's just see. Yeah, it fills it in for you. So that's fine. It comes up with a color. That tells me that it's actually worked. And then I'm just going to save that file. Now I want to come back and whilst I'm in this directory, so make sure you don't go and zip up this directory. Go in the directory, highlight everything, and then compress it or zip it depending on your operating system. So now we've got our Node.js-blue. Just call it Node.js blue. And what we're gonna do is upload this to Elastic Beanstalk and then deploy an updated version of our application. So back in application versions, let's click on upload. And this one I'm gonna call Node-blue. I'm gonna choose a file. I'm gonna find that file, which is in AWS Elastic Beanstalk. Here it is, the zip file, nodejsblue.zip. So that's all I need to do. I can upload my file. So now I have some new source code. Now it hasn't changed anything on my application. All we've done is we've simply uploaded the code. So we now have another version that we can potentially deploy to our environment. So what I'll do is I'm actually going to choose Node Blue. I'm going to go to Actions and then Deploy. And then now I'm going to choose my environment. I've only got one option. So I'm going to deploy it straight to my environment. What we should see if we go back to environments is an update is actually taking place. Okay, my update has completed successfully, didn't take too long. So now if I go back to this page here, give it a refresh, and now my application is blue. All right, so that's simply uploading a new version and then deploying that new version straight onto our application. Now, of course, we only had one instance in this case. By the way, you can go to EC2 and have a look there. You will see your instance running in EC2. What we might want to do is actually configure our updates on a separate instance. And then we can use the swap URLs functionality. So what we've done is we've just deployed a new version of our application straight on to the EC2 instance. Now, by the way, you can see that instance in EC2 if you go and have a look there. Now, we might not want to deploy an update directly to our live system. We might want to deploy it somewhere else first, check it, and then use the URLs functionality to swap URLs between environments. So that's what we're going to do now. What we need to do is go to our application, let's click on our application, and within the application, we're going to create a new environment. It's going to be a web server environment, so we can see the environment name is being populated for us. I'm just going to call this env2, just so I can be absolutely sure of which one this is. Then, what we're going to do is just choose the Node.js option again with a sample application. Now we know that's the green application. We've already changed our live environment to blue. So that's all I need to do. Let's just create this environment. And again, that will take a few minutes to create the environment for us. So my new environment, my second environment, environment 2, is now available. If I click on the link, I now get the green landing page. So I've got the blue one and the green one. Now, what I want to do now, because I've deployed a second version of my application, maybe I've run my update, it's there, and I want to swap the URLs. So in other words, I want to redirect the live traffic from one instance to the other one, across one environment to the other environment. The way we can do that is we go to Actions and Swap Environment URLs. And so here I just select the environment that I want to swap, click on Swap, and that's going to make that change for us. And you can see that's really quick. It says it's completed swapping the CNAMEs for the environments. So now if I click on Environment 2 using the URL here, I get the blue application. And if I come back and I go to my other environment, let's go to the original environment just down here, click on this one. Remember, this one was blue, now it's green. So that's how the swapping of URLs works. So that's it for this lesson. I've finished with this particular demonstration. So I'm going to terminate my environments one by one. So let's just select the name of the environment, pop that in the confirmation box. And of course, this will initiate the termination, the deletion of the resources via CloudFormation. I'll do the same with my second environment here, and that will clean everything up.